come on and share this jam with me.
Peach or plum or strawberry, any kind is fine. You see, come on and share this jam with me. I'll do my best to give this jam the sweetness it deserves.
And I'll keep it fresh. I'm jamming on these tasty preserves.
Ingredients in harmony,
we mix together perfectly. Come on and share this jam with me.
As you have just heard, this video is all about jam. More specifically, strawberry freezer jam. Normally, I'd just buy jam from the grocery store, but this is an assignment for Food Studies 30, Unit 8, Lesson 6. So, without further ado, let's begin. According to the recipe I was provided from the Craft Recipes website, to make this recipe, we'll require the following ingredients. 2 cups of prepared fruit. That is approximately 1 quart of ripe strawberries. 4 cups sugar. This should be measured into a separate bowl. 1 pouch of Certo brand fruit pectin. 2 tablespoons lemon juice. As well as clean containers to put the finished product in. First, I took the strawberries and opened the package and washed them. After this, I stemmed the leaves. Sometimes referred to as the hull. I attempted to crush them with a potato masher. As it wasn't working so well, Mum decided using the blender was a better idea, and so that's exactly what we did. I had 2 cups of strawberries according to the side of the blender, so I poured it into a separate bowl and started on the next step. This next step was very important. It was the sugar. Why is it so important, I hear you ask? That's because we need to use only the amount of sugar prescribed by the recipe. No more, no less. Otherwise, the jam will not become the proper consistency and it won't firm up and set. In this case, the recipe calls for 4 cups. Now the sugar has been measured. I put the sugar in with the strawberries and mixed it up.
And now it has to sit for 10 minutes.
I then measured 2 tablespoons of lemon juice and mixed it into the Certo branded pectin. Once the 10 minutes was up, I mixed this lemon pectin mixture in with the strawberries. I then stirred this mixture for 3 minutes. Finally, I put the jam in the sterilized jars. And now, through the magic of video, the jar is filled. I made sure to only fill it to within a half and an inch to the top, and wiped the rims of the jars off. I repeated this process and filled our second jar. We had more jam than expected, so I sterilized a plastic container with boiling water. Then I filled that container as well. Next, we put the lids on. And now we had to wait for a 24-hour period to let the jam set properly.
Tomorrow, tomorrow, we'll start the day tomorrow with a smile for you. I know tomorrow we'll be happy, and so tomorrow. tomorrow, make it snappy. Tomorrow, tomorrow, it soon will be tomorrow and be our day. We'll say a happy tomorrow to you.
Finally, we could test the jam. This was the consistency of the jam after it had set.
I really like it.
I tasted it as well and thought it was a bit too sweet for my taste. But it doesn't help that I don't have much of a sweet tooth. If I'm making toast, I personally will normally put either tuna or marmalade on it. I don't think I'll ever want to have both at the same time. I find that
strawberry jam tries very hard to please.